Hello everybody, so in this video I will show you how to use LimeSeg to compute curvatures of surface, so Gaussian curvature and mean curvature within the LimeSeg plugin in FIJI. So to do that, I will just first open a text window. Not that we care about the text window, but in templates you can actually find all the scripts that I will be using in this video, so you can repeat the steps. The first thing we're gonna do is to launch the demo vesicle segmentation. So this script is actually fetching some a data set which is made of two lipid vesicles. I can zoom in. Okay, segmentation is already done. And it's pretty nice because these vesicles actually have, okay, segmentation is done now. They have different sort of curvature. So you can see it here in the 3D viewer. I can zoom in by using the mouse wheel, and if I drag, I see the curvature. So you can already see that there's a saddle shape here, really well marked, and some positive curvature, negative curvature. So we have these two objects in LimeSeg, and the most convenient way to perform some operation is to use some Groovy scripts. So for instance, there's an example Groovy script here, which is list.properties. And you can go through it. It's basically looping through all LimeSeg objects, fetching the one that are present at time point one. So in this data set, there's only one time point, so it will be looping through all the objects. And then let's run it. It's printing for any point the position of the dots and the normal point of the dots. Here the MC and GC value corresponds to the local mean curvature and local Gaussian curvature. But since it hasn't been computed yet, this is a not a number value, and the val is actually corresponding to this float image value parameter, which is actually the pixel intensity located at the dots. So I'm speaking about dots, but maybe this will be more clear if I launch the graphical user interface command of LimeSeg. And in here, if I go to 3D view and I set this parameter to 0, so I first define this value to 0 and then to set cell 3D display. And then you can actually see the surface element of this object. And I will keep the other object as a mesh. Okay, so if you want to compute the local curvature, you actually need to get to this compute curvatures script. And this is launching the certain computation. So it will basically compute the local surface matrix parameter. And it does that by looking at all the neighboring dots within a certain range. And if you put a range, like for instance of 2, then the curvature will be computed with a very local neighbors. But if you put 5, then you will have something very smooth. So let's put 2.5, the original value, and run it. So if we find the log window somewhere here, you can actually see the process going on, and now it's already done for both objects. So if I relaunch list.properties, now you will actually see the curvature values that are now defined for each point. So the mean curvature here and the Gaussian curvature. So that's nice, and you can already do some computation based on this. But now if you want to display this curvature in the 3D viewer, you can actually go to the last script I will show you, which is display curvature 3D. and let's run it first, and I will explain what it does later on. Okay, so now that it's done, you can clearly see here that on the green part you have some positive mean curvature, and on the red part it's some negative mean curvature. And when it's gray, it's actually flat, so almost zero curvature. So here we can clearly see in the surface positive curvature, and here negative mean curvature. Now if we go back to the script, then you will see that there's some commands, and there's actually one which is working with a Gaussian curvature. So I uncomment this line, command this one. Now I run it, and then actually the value, the color code, is now corresponding to the Gaussian curvature. And you can clearly see here that you have a strong saddle shape, so meaning one curvature is negative, one is positive, so you have a negative Gaussian curvature, and this appears as red. If both curvatures are positive, this is green, and if the curvature is almost zero, like here on the flat bottom, then it's gray. So you can actually have a look on how this coloring is done. The class Gaussian curvature color lookup table is actually just defined into the Groovy script, and it's extending a certain class. And the important method in this class is this getColor method, which takes as an input the DotN structure, which is a dot structure used by LimeSeg. And based on any properties you can retrieve, you just output a float table, which is basically a float value for red, green, blue, and transparency, which is currently ignored. So here I retrieve the Gaussian curvature of the dot, and if the curvature is positive, then I basically increase the green value compared to 0.5, which is my medium gray. And if the curvature is negative, this is actually displayed as an increase in the red component of the color. The mean curvature lookup table class is basically the same, but it takes as an input the mean curvature value. And this parameter taken in the class is actually a way to highlight or not the little values of curvature. So if I, for instance, re-put the mean curvature, but I increase a lot this value, then everything will be fully green or fully red. And if I put a much lower value, like 40, then you see that it's much more gray. Or maybe let's do 4. And now you can see that almost everything is gray, and this part, which is highly curved, is a tiny bit green. If you want to retrieve the original colors based on different objects, you just need to specify this default class. And if I rerun it, then the 3D display is again back to the color of the object that is actually random in the command. So I hope that you like this video, and that you will be able to use LimeSeg for this sort of curvature computation. Thank you and goodbye.